Hi, I'm Craig, and I have eyes like a hawk with human eyes. And this is Mental Floss on YouTube. Today I'm going to answer Brian Currie's big question. On a clear day, how many miles can I see in every direction? How about on a hazy day? Well, Brian, the answer to your question really depends on circumstances. Like, some nights you can look up at the sky and see the Andromeda Galaxy, which is a full 2.5 million light years away. But you probably want more information than that. So that's what you're going to get. Maybe you don't want more, but we like to talk about stuff at you, so we're going to do that. Let's get started. According to a study done in 1942, the human eye can actually see a single flame burning 30 miles away. That's around 50 kilometers, but that could only happen if the Earth were flat. The Earth ain't flat. We can actually see much further than we do see. It's that darn horizon that gets in the way. The horizon, by the way, is where the Earth meets the sky. You've heard of it. You've seen it. On Instagram. Since that's the case, you've probably already figured out that the altitude has an impact on how far you can see. So, if you're an average height of 5'7" and standing on the ground, the horizon is approximately 2.9 miles away. So, people can see 2.9 miles away. Boom. Done. No. Unfortunately, it's not that simple. Humans can't come up with a simple formula that works for every situation. And that's because we have things like atmospheric refraction, which is how light passes through different mediums in different ways. Thanks to that, things like air pressure and temperature are actually affecting the way you see the horizon. Also, that big guy at the top of the Sears Tower when you're trying to look out the window, but he just won't get out of the way. You pay 20 bucks to get up there. Then, of course, as Brian so astutely mentioned, there are factors like haziness and fog. If you wanted to see really far, you could hop on a plane or climb Mount Everest, but then you would probably have a cloud get in your way. All of that said, Dr. Andrew T. Young, who I will call Young Mr. T, of San Diego State University, has developed this formula that takes refraction into consideration. All you gotta do is insert your eye level in feet, and it will give you an approximation of your distance to the horizon in miles. But like I said, no formula you find for this will be perfect. There are just too many variables. If all this confusing refraction stuff is too much for you, you can just calculate how many miles there are between you and the horizon. There's a link in the doobly-doo to an online calculator that will doobly-doo the work for you. Thanks for watching Mental Floss on YouTube, made by these lovely people. If you have a question of your own, leave it in the comments. See you next week from an average distance.